students, welcome back to Economics Chapter 1 Development. I hope now you are familiar with the Google Classroom of our school. The first part of this chapter was already taken by Bin Seaman. In that class, you studied how to compare different nations, states on the basis of income. Now we will begin with the second part of this chapter. Today, we will discuss different topics like income and other criteria, public facilities, human development index, and sustainability of development. Let us come to the topic income and other criteria. Besides income, what are the other parameters of development? Now, let's take the example of two states, Kerala and Haryana. Haryana has much higher per capita income as compared to Kerala. However, if we talk in terms of development, we would say Kerala is much ahead of Haryana. What is the reason behind it? Because when we are talking about development, we are not just merely including per capita income as we did in the case of growth. Here, we have a table of per capita income of selected states. The per capita income of Haryana was 1,62,034 rupees. Kerala 1,55,516. Then Bihar 34,168. From this table, which state has higher per capita income? Haryana. From this slide, we can understand Haryana has higher per capita income or higher growth as compared to Kerala. If we are talking about development, we are just including other parameters like infant mortality rate, literacy rate, and net attendance ratio. Now, you just recall your memories. We already studied all these concepts in our 9th standard. What is IMR or infant mortality rate? Infant mortality rate indicates the number of children that die before the age of 1 year as a proportion of 1,000 live children born in that particular year. If the infant mortality rate is higher, the region is not well in terms of development. As per 2016 census, the infant mortality rate of Kerala was 12 and the infant mortality rate of Haryana was 36. Why Kerala has lower infant mortality rate? What is the reason behind this? Because Kerala has adequate facilities of health and education. Another parameter is literacy rate. Literacy rate measures the proportion of literate population in the 7 and above age group. From the slide, you can see the literacy percentage of various states. If the literacy rate is higher, that means there is higher development. The next one is net attendance ratio. Net attendance ratio is the total number of children of age group 14 and 15 years attending school as a percentage of total number of children in the same age group. Higher the net attendance ratio, higher will be the development. Now, let's take the example of three states and compare their data. Here, we have a comparative data on Haryana, Kerala, and Bihar. From this slide, the infant mortality rate of different states like Haryana 36, Kerala 12, and Bihar 42. Then literacy rate, Haryana 82%, Kerala 94%, and Bihar 62%. Then net attendance ratio, Haryana 61, Kerala 83, Bihar 43. From this slide, we can understand Kerala has high literacy rate, then net attendance ratio, and lower per capita income. Another important parameter is public facilities. Money in your pocket cannot buy all the goods and services that you may need to live well. For example, a pollution-free environment, unadulterated medicines, protection from infectious diseases, etc. Kerala has low infant mortality rate because it has adequate provision of basic health and educational facilities. Similarly, in some states, the public distribution system functions well. Health and nutritional status of people in such states is likely to be better. In the first picture, you can see the effective use of public distribution system or ration shops in Kerala. From the second picture, you can see the contribution of health centers in improving the health facilities of Kerala. Third picture shows the importance of educational system. Finally, the fourth picture depicts the importance of nutritional food in each person's life. All these contribute towards the better public facilities provided by each government.